Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining me for another 5 good minutes with the Word. I'm Barry Bryson. We're going to conclude our conversation about Peter and his encounters with Jesus today by talking about the unique qualities, I think, that we see in terms of Peter's relationship to Jesus. Peter was not one of the 12, and one wonders, he was in Jerusalem at the time Jesus was around, and just by dint of knowing when his education had to have taken place, and it did take place in Jerusalem at the great synagogue, so he had to be there. He was in town when all this was happening. It's difficult to imagine that he did not see Jesus, hear Jesus, cross paths with Jesus in some way. It's almost impossible. We forget how small a space that walled city was, and what a large celebrity Jesus was there at the end of his public ministry. So it's almost impossible to believe that he didn't, with his own eyes, see Jesus, and with his own ears, hear Jesus. But they had no relationship until the Damascus Road, which we talked about at length earlier in one of our 5 good minutes. And the way Jesus called him personally, the way Jesus' own voice spoke to him from heaven, the way Jesus, in Hebrew, quoted a Greek author, Euripides, knowing that Paul would understand exactly what he was referring to. It's a moment of intimacy and intimate knowledge that that Paul experienced, that Paul continued to experience and to crave throughout the rest of his life. The traditional thought among biblical scholarship nowadays is that Jesus presented a unique teaching that was transformative for all the world. And when he died, his death began a movement. And then Paul comes along a few years later, becomes a part of that movement, and turns that movement into an institution by establishing elders in cities, and by, through his copious writing and his travels and his teachings, establishing not a movement but a church. Well, God did use Paul as a tool in that way to help establish congregations all over the empire. But I think it's so misguided to see Paul as taking something Jesus has started and turning it into something completely different. That just is not what happened. Paul is Christ-centered in ways that are unique to him. And nearly every one of Paul's letters, and all of Paul's letters, let me rephrase that. Everything that Paul says is focused on, like a laser beam, on the cross itself, on the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, he says, we preach Christ crucified, verse 23, to the Jews a stumbling block, to the Gentiles foolishness, but to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and wisdom of God. He says in chapter 2, verse 2, I determined to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And every one of his letters begins with the theology of the cross. And then he applies that truth of the cross to the particular concerns of that congregation. And so the Apostle Paul is in no way ossifying Christianity, but he is continually focusing and making the center of gravity the moment of Jesus' death, his burial, and his resurrection. And the best place he communicates that personally for himself is in Philippians chapter 3. And in Philippians chapter 3, a passage that we've looked at earlier in this conversation about Paul, he's talking about his advanced education. Now, he was the best of his generation, but he threw it all away, threw it literally in the garbage can so that he could know Jesus. He says in chapter 3, verse 7, whatever things were gained to me, those things I've counted loss for the sake of Christ. More than that, I count all things to be loss in view of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as trash in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own derived from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, righteousness which comes from God on the basis of faith, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection, the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his death, in order that I may attain the resurrection among the dead. He says, I want to have the full experience of Jesus. I want to know Jesus through the scriptures. I want to live Jesus every day. I want to suffer like Jesus. I want to die like Jesus. I cannot get close enough to Jesus. We see in the Apostle Paul this magnetism that Jesus has in every fiber of his being, in the way we saw it in the Apostle Peter earlier. I don't know a better expression of Paul's encounter with Jesus than that. Paul's an intimidating, daunting figure to get to know because he's so intense, because his mind is on fire, because his feelings are so strong, because his logic is perfect, because his example is so difficult to follow. But Paul opens himself up to us like no other New Testament person does, except for Jesus himself. And let's just get to know him inside out. And when we go to the center, we see love for Jesus. Thank you for joining me for another 5 good minutes. And we've concluded our study of the apostles. We'll pick up with another topic next time.